Welcome back, you're watching Storyboard. Last year, Mindshare announced its intention to place its business unit FAST, short for Future Adaptive Specialist Team, at the heart of its business as a part of an ongoing transformation program. They also appointed Gowthaman Ragothaman as the Global Chief Strategy Officer for FAST. We catch up with Gowthaman, or G-Man as we call him, and speak to him about many things including data, measurement and the future impact of blockchain technology. Let's take a look at this chat.
Inventing Sophia.
What do you think should be required for robot citizenship?
G-Man, yep. Crazy conversations about blockchain.
Yeah.
What is happening on blockchain? Crazy conversations about ad avoidance.
Right.
Crazy conversations about 1,000 things that marketers read in the headlines, they don't know how to react. They don't know what to do with it. They don't know whether it's a today's danger or a danger
right.
5 years ago. So let's start with blockchain.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, should I be bothered? Should a marketer be bothered?
Most definitely, yes, yeah. The reason is, I think some of these things, you know, we underestimate when it is coming.
Right.
And sometimes you overestimate when it is going to come later as well. But blockchain as a technology is something that is coming here and now.
Mm.
And often what happens is we confuse blockchain with Bitcoin
right.
and say that, oh, it's another cryptocurrency and it is something else that is underground or not yet recognized or illegal and
right.
therefore it's not applicable to me. But blockchain technology is what is being used by Bitcoin, but the technology is coming.
So I'll tell you what, simplify blockchain for the viewers
okay.
first.
See, blockchain, to my mind, if you have to really say, I want people to think of it as four elements to it. Okay, there is one which is getting the data right. It's a data set. And the data set becomes a ledger. And the ledger is cryptographically maintained through a consensus. So I just want to remember four words only.
Right.
Data set, ledger, cryptography, and consensus.
Right.
So what happens is, if you remove the Bitcoin mindset, it's about maintaining a database in a central repository in a form that can be cryptographically locked
right.
or managed
right.
or edited. And that editing happens through a wider consensus, not by one individual.
Right.
So you say this to everybody, then it suddenly becomes more applicable to many industries.
Right.
Like real estate, they use it a lot now as a technology.
So give me an illustration of how it's applied in real estate.
Real estate, because wherever there are multiple partners involved
right.
and who don't trust each other,
right.
you can use this.
Right.
Because the price of a property, what comes into the construction of the house and to the sale.
So now put this for me into
right.
data set,
yes.
cryptography, ledger.
So let's take a real estate. Okay, a data set is the cost of the house, registration charges, construction charges, society maintenance charges, various things that goes into the price of the property, right? And that has multiple players involved in it. There is a provider of furniture inside the construction of the house, the provider of various raw materials, I can list down various things, right?
Right.
So the cost component is, in a data set, is listed as elements that goes into the construction of the house and the sale and the cost attached to it. Each of them is being provided by multiple vendors. So, and the end consumer sees one final number. And that's being sold to a particular, through a real estate builder or whatever it is, let's say. How do you know that all these prices are correct?
Right.
It's a claimed value from you or from me when I see the house. In a blockchain methodology, each of these data set is approved by at least multiple vendors or a consortium of people who are involved in the entire value chain, not by one claimant.
Yeah.
So that automatically brings proof to the system.
Right.
So I can relate to that to many other industries. For example, today I read somewhere else that diamond industry is going to use this technology because the number of cuts that goes into the diamond, the authenticity of the diamond, the sourcing of the diamond, there are multiple players in the value chain. So instead of one person claiming it, the system as a record maintaining by a ledger, by a consensus, gives much more authenticity to the whole
thing. One of the things is it's 100% consensus.
There are various protocols.
Tending to,
that's right. There are various protocols involved in it.
Right.
Minimum they say is 60% consensus.
Okay, right.
So at least you should get 60% of them approving to this ledger of data sets.
Yeah.
So you take that to media in our industry, claiming of the ad, payment of the ads, whether the ad has been appeared in the right, whether ad appeared or not. Did it appear in the right right context? Did it appear in the right space? And how many people saw it? Are all claims today by various partners, right? Which is why suddenly the transparency issue, which came up some time back, suddenly this is being seen as a problem, a solution to solve the problem. Which is why quite a few people are now talking about how can I use this technology to sort of build trust, or even amongst untrusted parties, how can they come together to bring some kind of transparent recording
validation.
Of that, validation of activities.
Right.
So today we have them. We have monitoring agencies, we have media agencies, we have clients, we have various partners involved in it. And the digital and the technology intervention has brought in at least 16 players, I'm saying 10, 15 players. And if you look at a tech stack today when it is assembled, minimum there are 10 parties involved.
Right.
All of them are in their own way coming in and going out. But from a marketer's point of view, he's seeing it's a confusion of logos on a chart, right? So this can solve it. This can really bring the relevance of each one of them. Everybody plays a role in a common ledger. That's the important thing. But the problem we have today is none of us are ready in keeping our data books right.
When you say none of us, just expand that us.
Both the agencies and the clients here. I'm being honest about it. I mean, even the... even the well-maintained or thoroughly professional marketing organizations do not have their data in one place, do not have the data sets in rightly assembled and maintained, because the data sets are sitting in different silos. The sales department has their own data, the CRM team has their own data,
right.
Media is sitting in somewhere else, insights sitting in somewhere else. So unless and until these things are sorted out first, which essentially means, in my view, the digital transformation is a prerequisite for blockchain adoption.
Right.
That is where the biggest challenge today is. And if you don't get our data strategy right, you might just say, wow, blockchain is coming and it's all giving me transparency.
And you're not ready, not a chance.
We're not ready, nobody is ready.
Right. Okay, now, G-Man, you might be in Singapore today, but you've spent enough time in India, and you still have oversight over, say, Pepsi
right.
in India
right.
and so on. So tell me, in the Indian context, where unfortunately there have been huge delays on anything which required industry-wide consensus.
Right.
Measurement is one, you know it well. You know, thankfully, BARC is sorted. Thankfully, we've got IRS again.
Mm-hmm.
But industry-wide consensus is difficult. So how do you see those challenges for blockchain in India? Because if India screws up on this, there's a problem.
It's a good question. I don't have an answer. But if we really want to get to the bottom of digital ROI, this might be the answer to it
right.
today. And we are still now struggling to have real ROI of social media, the real ROI of search, the real ROI of advertising, how many impressions are really working, the bot-led impressions, did the human really see it or not? If these are questions which are grappling in the industry today, and it's as much as here and anywhere else in the world. So it is coming. I genuinely believe this technology or this approach should answer these questions, one. And two is, I don't think India can stay away from this global movement on this. Some of this technology can even be run out of some one country for the entire world, because all you need is...
All these consensus and protocols.
Protocols, isn't it? All you need
and
is...
And cleaning up your own data sets.
Yeah, that is what we should be focusing on, because network clients who have businesses everywhere else in the world might choose to say, I really want to use this across the world. Then we have to do it.
Let's close this. I want one sentence from you on why a marketer should read up
If anybody believes that data drives creativity, and data and technology is at the heart of marketing, they have to do this. It's coming.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Gowthaman.
Thanks.
With that, it's a wrap on Storyboard this week. You can catch all of our content on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Thanks for watching, and we'll be back same time next week. See you soon.